Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.4 Developer Beta 1. This is available to developers and soon to public beta testers. The final release will probably not be out for another month or so. Now this came in at a very large 4.04 gigabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. It was in the 3 gigabyte range depending on the device you're talking about, but for the iPhone 6S Plus, the iPhone XR, and even the iPad Pro, they were all in the 3 gigabyte range. Anytime you're going from a public version to a beta or from a beta back to a public version, it's going to be a very large install. And this took probably 30 to 60 minutes to install depending on the device. So it took a very long time. Now, aside from that, Apple also released macOS betas along with watchOS betas, Apple TV betas, and an update for Xcode betas as well. So there's a bunch of new things they're kind of pushing in the background, and there are some new features with this update. Not a ton, but there are some new ones. Now let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 17E5223H, and this particular build brings a few new features and changes. Some are actually pretty good, so I'll go over those in just a moment. But as we get closer to the letter A at the end of the build number, right now we're on H, as we get closer to A, we're closer to a final release. So it looks like it's going to be some time, at least probably 4 beta versions at this point. So it's going to be a while until this fully releases, but let's go over some of the new features with it. Now, the first thing is there is a modem update. I actually had very good LTE on iOS 13.3.1, but there is a modem update on here that will affect LTE and cellular. Now, the first feature is one that was supposed to be released when iOS 13 initially came out, but it was never included in it. And that was sharing folders with other people in the Files app. So if you go into Files, and then maybe I want to share the Downloads folder or the Document folder, I can press and hold on it, and then maybe go to Share. And under Share, I can go to Add People down here at the bottom. So if I add people, now I can add people to actually share this folder with me. And as I make changes within the folder, maybe to a document or something like that, they'll see those changes and be able to modify them as well, along with whatever I'm doing. So very similar to what you see with, say, Google Docs and things like that. So that's now available for everyone with this beta update. When it finally releases, everyone should have it. Now, the next thing that they've updated and a new feature has to do with Memoji. So if we go into a message and where we have Memoji stickers, they've actually added 9 new ones. So there's a bunch of new stickers here. I actually never use these, but if you use these stickers, you'll have some new ones as you scroll through them. So anything from the shocked face to a face with hears, eyes rolling, and a lot more. You'll see face palm and frown faces and things. Quite a few of them were there before, but there are 9 new ones. So that's something they've added as well. Now, Apple has actually brought family sharing to the TV app in this update. So where you could share movies and music and things like that with family members, you can also see it now in the TV app. So once they're updated to this version, you'll see their family sharing here, and you can go into that and you'll see each person's individual sharing. So maybe someone else purchased a movie, it should show up here. And then they've updated Mail to include some icons that should have been there a long time ago. So we'll go back into Mail, and I think they've reverted to this because now we have Reply on the far right, we have Flag, Folder, and Delete. And in the previous version with 13.3.1, you'll see all we had was Reply and Delete, or a little trash bin there. They've finally reverted it back, and I think that's a much better way to do it. So that's something they've updated as well. Now, there's also support for new call controls and third-party navigation in CarPlay. So this is for developers. They can update third-party navigation apps with different call types. So you can see that a little bit differently or differently as far as visually, but until app developers update that, you won't see any of that. There's also a new backend feature that you don't see that is for future use, and that is a new car key implementation. So what that means is cars that now allow you to use NFC to open and unlock your car and drive away, you'll be able to integrate that directly into the phone instead of having to use their app necessarily. So maybe it'll be into HomeKit or something like that, CarKit we may see next. So that's for unlocking, driving, and sharing with NFC car keys. And then finally, with developers, they can now sell Mac and iOS apps as a bundled purchase. So for example, if you have the app Things 3 you normally would buy things for your iPhone, then for your iPad, and then for your Mac. They can bundle that all together if they want to do that. Now on the iPad, while there isn't anything particularly special that they've added, they have added some shortcuts into Photos. So if you go into Photos and you have your different photos here and you hold down Command on a keyboard, you'll see all of the different shortcuts. So now they've made it so you can switch to years, months, days, and all photos just a little bit easier by holding Command and hitting the number one. There's a bunch of other shortcuts as well that they've added, but specific to the iPad, that's really all there is in this particular update for iPad OS. Now there are a few background updates for developers as well, along with authorizations and things like that, but there are some known issues that they actually mentioned within Notes. So a couple of them have to do with iPhone 11, iPhone 11 Pro, and iPhone 11 Pro Max using the configuration profile. Installation using the restore image isn't currently available for those particular models. So that's something they've noted with this update. Also, after viewing specific app settings and then returning to the main settings page, it could crash. So that's something that they've noted. So there's definitely a few bugs in here. And then also within Photos, it may not sync as expected to Apple Watch. And then also if the Siri interface is no longer appearing, they suggest you actually restart your phone. So those are all things that they need to fix. And that's normal with earlier betas. But the good thing is they've reverted those buttons on the Mail app. They've fixed quite a few things in the background. And I would imagine there's quite a few more features that we just haven't found yet. And I wanted to talk about performance and battery life as well. And performance overall, well, it's only been out for a couple hours, so we don't really know how it is over days. But as far as smoothness and things, it's fine on the 11 Pro Max. Here I also have the oldest supported phone, the iPhone 6S Plus, and speed seems to be okay here. Things are loading fast. And I'll talk about the Geekbench scores in a moment. But things seem to be loading fast. You'll see music opened quickly. It's fine. And just using it in general should be about the same as it was before or better. Now with the iPhone XR, I know a lot of people wanted to see this particular phone as well. Again, it's having the same sort of reaction. A lot of people said with iOS 13.3.1, it was having some issues. Right now it seems to be okay. Opening different applications, switching between them. And also RAM management, I actually tested that on the iPhone 11 Pro Max by opening about 20 applications and I didn't have a single app reload. So I went through all of my applications, went back to YouTube and it didn't reload. So that's a pretty good sign. Now battery life will take a few days to measure, but on iOS 13.3.1, it was pretty mixed. I found that more people actually had good battery than not. But battery life for me in general has been okay. You'll see I had 2 hours and 15 minutes of screen on time, 41 minutes of screen off time today, and I've used about a little over 31% of my battery. So you'll see we're at 69% battery. So in that amount of time, I'm only getting about 8 hours of screen on time today, but it does go from about 10 to 12 normally if I was to use it all day long and not plug it in. But like I said, it will take a few days to measure to see how it is in this update, and I'll let you know with a follow-up video later on. Now let's take a look at the Geekbench scores. I'll put all these phones out so you can take a look at them. On the iPhone 11 Pro Max, I scored 1,334, which is pretty close to what we had before. And then for multi-core, 3,338. If we take a look at the history, we'll go over to CPU here. On history, let's find January 28th. It was very similar. So you can see here is February 5th. Here's January 28th with the previous one. So we're very close as far as Geekbench scores, and that just means things should perform as expected, and basically they should perform as they were with 13.3.1. Now let me lay out all of these devices so we can take a look at all this, the Geekbench scores together. From left to right, I have the iPad Pro from 2018, 12.9. Then I have the iPhone 6S Plus, then the iPhone XR, then the iPhone 8 Plus, and then the iPhone 11 Pro Max. So this should give you a general idea of what your scores should be near. The 6S Plus, the single core score, is a little bit low at 397. Had I given it more time, it would probably go up. So they may go up a little bit over time after all the background processes have stopped. Now with iOS 13.4, when it comes out in maybe a month or two, I would expect the new emoji to be in place as well that was shown off recently. So there's a bunch of new ones that were introduced by Unicode. And then iOS 14 is where we'll see the major changes. So don't expect any major changes until we see iOS 14 revealed for the first time in June, and then a final release in September. That's pretty much how it goes every year. Expect refinements and some major tweaks and feature adds with 13.4. Maybe we'll see an iOS 13.5, but iOS 13.4 seems to be decent right now. We'll only know in a few days if it actually is pretty good. But let me know your thoughts about it in the comments below, how it's been for you over the past couple hours or days by the time you're watching this. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.